Hey, and welcome back to another episode of the Road to Opiate Zero. In the last few episodes, we actually did reach Opiate. And now it's time to get some great items. So, we already farmed for pretty much perfect Pimpernels. Like this corrosive one over here. Just look at it. Malamun Grip, Dahlstock, Jacob Scope, Corrosive, Banbury. Perfect. We farmed for Pimpernels, and we also farmed for a pretty much, well, not a perfect B-Shield, but we did get an inflammable B-Shield. Unfortunately, it still has one torque part on it, so it isn't perfect, but it's a great one, so I'm very happy with that as well. Then we decided to farm for another Sham Shield at OP level 8. Oh, yep, the hot loaders explode. Boar? Yeah, well, he died, so that's the most important part. And also, I forgot to put my phone down from my desk again. Sending his ammo? The bunker is dead, pretty much. I didn't need no ammo. You know what, Brick, just for that comment, I'm gonna finish him with melee. I don't need ammo. Doesn't look like we got a champ shield. This sniper just flew off in front of our faces. Hey, that is a longbow transfusion, but not in slag. And also a high fuse time. Who is doing that? Is that you guys? Stop it. So, what did we get? Nothing useful at all. This could have been good, but it really isn't. Oh, I thought it was another pearlescent, but again, it's the blue and the green beam crossing. So that didn't work. Unfortunately, we got nothing good. But that happens most of the time, right? I quickly want to take a look downstairs. Nothing over here, except some money. We're almost at the money cap, actually. 78 million. Yeah, money isn't very important to us. To any character in Borderlands 2, honestly. Only if you really want to buy your rocket ammo back, if you use rockets a lot. But there's way more efficient ways to overcome that little problem. There he is. Alright, and that is the bunker down once again. Now the bunker would have been a fun grind if he didn't have like his animations and the flying rotations. Otherwise it would have been such a fast farm on Zero. I mean it still is, don't get me wrong. Unfortunately, most of this fight is just waiting for him to complete his animations. Meleed. Ah, there's the double shot. Was looking for that. Hey, a crammed hand cannon with a Jacob's grip. I don't know why I got excited by that. What else is there? A melee damage relic? No thanks. And nothing good over here. Well, that's a disappointing find. There is actually a chest in this area somewhere. Like a hidden one. Let's see if I still know where to find it. Not there. Yeah, there should be like a little gap in the map where there's an developer chest. I know about the chest up there, but that one isn't very good. There should be a better one. But I totally forgot. Oh, it's here. Okay. A droog. We don't need that. Okay, so it's where this turret spawns in the story mission. And apparently it only opens after you kill the bunker, I guess. But it's quite a long walk. Now, one of the next farms we have to do after getting this new sham is either getting a better grog nozzle, but we're not gonna melee anytime soon, or getting all the perfect Lyudas, or at least some decent ones. That is gonna take a while, but I think that's what we have to do, because that's gonna help us kill raid bosses. Ooh, maybe we should do the Sandhawks first, so we can get that out of the way, and then we can farm Hyperius. We only need a Fire Pimpernel for Hyperius. And some Singularity Grenades. And Boar. Well, actually, I do want to get some perfect Bone of the Ancients first, so... Oh yeah, of course, this is... And that's why we started getting this Sham Shield at OP8. Because I want to basically get to the loot midgets as quickly as I can. And as quickly as we can do that by rocket jumping, right? And it would be nice to have an OP8 Sham instead of an OP3 Sham that I have right now. So that's why we're at the bunker right now. So the next thing we'll do is farming loot midgets. And no Sham once again. Some stuff over there, but nothing significant. Right? Nope. So yeah, let's... You know what? Let's finish the run every time with that chest over there. Elemental relic, not bad, but not very good either. And nothing over here, so unfortunate. I'm quickly gonna alt tab and see if everything is working. It is. So this farm shouldn't take too long, honestly. But so far we haven't been very lucky with the bunker on OP8. Yeah, I'm getting the hang of these double shots now. That buzzard sound, so deafening. If this guy could fly still. Oh, okay. That was a good boar. Yeah, the Pimpernel is such a good weapon for boring. This is why we're gonna use that on Hyperius. But first, all the Bone of the Ancients, then the Sandhawks, and then we'll continue with the Scarlet DLC. Bam! But that didn't do too much damage. Is that the no? That's a green shield. Another almost pearlescent juke. And that's another run without merits. Yet, because we still have a chest to open. Almost 1500 loaders killed in total. Not bad. Hey, we got some class mods. Torque Fire Rate, Torque Magazine Size. Nah, that's not a very good one. But, Lethal Ninja. That's decent. Unpredictable Killer, One Shot Sniper. Hey! Let's see. The One Shot Sniper. That could be better than the one we have. Oh, and our inventory is glitched again. Gotta be a bit more careful with that. Okay, yep, that's just plain better in every way. Does take quite a bit more of the shield capacity, but that's okay. We'll drop the old one and we'll save quit. And in the top right of the screen you can see that we have to turn the don't copy that floppy. Of course we already did that, but we did it on save only, so that's why we still have it active for now. Eventually we might just turn it in to get rid of that message over there. But maybe we want some new variants of the Pimpernels later on, who knows. Maybe I want bladed if I want to go with a hybrid sniper and... Oh, okay, I just wanted to slag him, but then I forgot I couldn't slag, and then he died already. Great. Maybe I'll want to go with a melee slash sniper hybrid build. Who knows? And then like a slag bladed Pimpernel could be really good. Ah, we don't have to walk all the way around actually, we can probably drop down here, can we? No, that would kill us. That wouldn't be very effective. All right, Mr. Bunker. BNK3R. No scope. What a douche, he almost killed me. Don't think I saw a sham, but we were quite far away. Swift shot, no, we don't want that. This guy is still alive. For now. Yeah, you better die quickly. What is that? An SMG? Disturbed infiltrator, blah blah blah. Well, oh, he did will drop a purple grenade, but that is not very helpful either. Okay, let's see if we can actually take that shortcut I was talking about. Preparing to strike. Oh, this works as well. Well, it might look good because it's E-Tech, but it isn't actually very good. Hopefully we can find some E-Tech snipers in those chests. Eventually. And my next playthrough is gonna be on Axton. And it's gonna be lots of fun. I will start the Axton playthrough before I have finished the Zero one, just to break up all the farming a little bit from time to time. I will probably post them like interchangeably, the videos, I don't know. I just make two playlists and I'll see whatever I play and then I'll upload it as soon as I can. Now I'm actually at the point of with Zero that I don't have any more clips pre-recorded, so at the moment, at the date of the release of this video, oh, this is where I'm at. I'm farming for the sham and trying to get to the loot midget soon. Okay, Bunker's dead, but we need to second wind. Bunker isn't gonna do that for us. In the meantime, I should just loot this chest all the time, right? Why shouldn't I? And I'm excited, because on my Axton, I'm gonna use lots of more explosive weapons and more RPGs offensively instead of just for rocket jumping. It's gonna be great, a new experience. And I only have played one Axton so far. I did level him to 72. Then did the Digistruct peak up to OP2, and then I just quit playing him. Even though I do actually have a cool pearlescent weapon, like the Bearcat. It's pretty good on Axton. Yeah, I got quite a lot of cool stuff for Axton. But, as I said, I won't continue playing that character for the video playthroughs. I will only do video playthroughs on characters that I have recorded from level 1 to max level, basically. Although, I might just jump into a new character at like level 30, because I already have like an Axton at level, well, maybe like level 18 or 17 that I started playing recently. I might just jump into that, because, but I don't know. I'll see how I feel about that. I will definitely switch out stuff with the other accounts from the playthroughs, so I won't have to farm the Pimpernel and the Bee and the Sham again over and over. And I would also like to start a new Krieg for a new series, but maybe I'll do Maya first, because Maya is also very good for, well, lots of stuff. Although, I might just do a Gunzerker then, because he's a lot easier to kill certain raid bosses with. And that can help me get better stuff for my other characters as well. So much stuff to do. Oh my, my ears. So much stuff to do, and so little time it seems sometimes, you know? But then again, the playtime on this Zero, which is now OP8, is probably only like 1 day and like 10 hours in total? Not quite sure. And the weird thing is, for some reason I always come back to the assassin. I already have leveled 3 or 4 assassins up to OP8 and farmed all the gear myself, even all the pimpernels and such. But now that I have started recording it, it's actually... Hey, was that the Shen? I don't think it was. Why did I think I saw the Shen? But now that I started recording, I feel like it's okay to interchange some items like the Sandhawk and the Pimpernel. And for example, that cool level 50 iron that we found, that's perfect. I just don't want to get... I want to be able to use it again, you know? Now, why did I think I saw a shield? I think I saw one drop through the floor or something, but it probably wasn't a sham. Hey, there is that an E-Tech sniper? Oh no, it's a submachine gun. It could have been the hybridification. Looked like the Hyperion sniper that we used at like level 60 to level 72. Alright, there's lots of purple stuff though, I like that, but they're all not very good. Now, I will check if there's anything falling through the ground. That's a blue Clasmod that we don't need. Another one. And some iridium. Yeah, so I don't think there was any unique drops. And the only unique drops could be the Sham and the Bitch, the submachine gun, the Hyperion Bitch. It's a really good weapon, especially early on, but I don't think it has elements, so it does start to fall off a little in the UVHM. But I'm still debating on my Axton that I'm gonna play next, because I just said that I want to have like level 1 to OP8 all like recorded, but then again on this Zero there's also I think 2 episodes, it's 11 and 21, that were corrupted and I couldn't retrieve, so basically that's also lost footage. And I already have an Axton right now that I started playing like 1 or 2 weeks ago, that's already level 18, and that means I don't have to do the very very early game anymore that I have done hundreds of times by now. So I think I'll just continue with that one at like level 18 or so. He just reached the wildlife exploitation and he started farming loot midgets. Oh my, I started loot midgets, I should say, on Axton. Yeah, I think I'll hop into there with my new series. Now the nice thing is, Bunker actually helps you stack Critical Ascension as well. So, we pretty much one-shot everything in a crit now. You know what, let's test that. We have a Calipene, right? Or a Muckamuck. We don't need fire damage here. Yeah, we have a Tum-Tum Muckamuck. It's pretty much perfect at OP8. That should do a lot of crit damage. Oh, yeah, you don't see damage numbers if he's in that phase. And of course, by equipping the sniper from our inventory, we managed to get rid of all our stacks that we got. But we'll check it next time. We'll get some stacks, then we'll kill a loader with a crit. Wow. These drops are terrible. Corrosive cloud, a green weapon, a blue weapon, grenade. At least you could have dropped something over here. Bunker. A Snyder. Ooh, I like Sniders. But unfortunately, well, there could have been an item dropped through the floor, so let's check it out. Iridium and money. Yeah, most of the time, weapons. Oh, there is actually a weapon. It's a purple submachine gun. Most of the time, only class mods, money, and iridium fall through the floor, but sometimes weapons fall through it as well. Now, I wouldn't know about shields, but I can imagine they could also fall through. Nothing too great. Now I do have, like early on I farmed for a Logan's gun, right, to retrieve ammo with. But now that we have a Sham and the Bada Boom also gives lots of ammo back, because one bullet splits up into six pellets. Basically you can absorb up to six rocket ammo with just one shot of the Bada Boom. So what I'm trying to say is I probably won't have to use the Logan's gun ever again. Although regening ammo with the Bada Boom will put you out of position a little bit, or it will make you jump and move slightly. So there could be instances where I want to just stand still in a corner and quickly try and want to... Oh, nice critical ascension. Where I quickly want to try and retrieve some cheeky ammo. Okay, that was okay damage. Don't die instantly. 16 million damage, was that? With death mark and slag. Not as much as I'd hoped it to be, with 34 stacks of critical ascension. White relics. Man, I was so focused on the loot that I completely forgot to kill that loader, but... Swift Spy Plasma. Ooh, cooldown rate 53%. That is not bad. But Velocity, Ambush, and Unforeseen. Those are skills I all... Besides Ambush, I never use. I could use it just for the cooldown rate, but then again, 53%... this is 33. Okay, that's not very good, actually. Oh, okay, so it is a lot better for the cooldown rate. But I'm not gonna pick up another relic just for the cooldown rate. That's a bit too much. I'll probably find a better Legendary Hunter class mod later on, when we come across a tubby. Unsuspectingly, I should say.
Move for the kill.
Hyperion with the Flood of Grip. Well, I would like to get a unique drop from the bunker now. Preferably the Sham. Because so far we haven't been... we haven't found anything yet this episode. Well... did we find anything? I don't know. We did find a legendary, like the Jacob's assault rifle, the hammer buster on the last episode from the bunker as a world drop. That was pretty cool. But as you know, or as you might note, Jacob assault rifles hit as fast as you can pull the trigger. And I found the hammer buster with a Hyperion. With a Vladov grid. So that adds fire rate. But adding fire rate to a Jacob's weapon isn't achieving anything. Wow, that's lots of stacks. Oh yeah, I can't slag them because that will kill them. But I could just slag them with my grenade. Oh no! Ooh, almost fell off the map. That would have been stupid. What was that? 12 million damage? Okay. That's Death Mark and the Deception Shot. 27 million, okay. Yeah, Deception makes a lot of difference. But still, 27 million. I expected more from this Tum Tum Makamak. Again, no sham. The Lucid Venom. Cool name. But no sham. And it's not like we need the sham for farming the loot midgets, but I would like to get one. And, you know, the scout, another one. We found so many scouts this playthrough. But, yeah, I wanted to say that when I, like, have a farm in mind, I'd rather just suck up some bad luck and keep farming for it until we get it, then to come back for it later. Because then you have literally achieved nothing. Oh god. Oh! Saved it! Whew. That was so close, I almost fell off. You know, I'd rather just keep on going. Because you get rewarded eventually, right? That's how RNG works. If you spend long enough, you'll eventually get what you're looking for. And yes, in looters and shooters and MMORPGs, that for some goals you could spend over 200 hours and still find nothing. But in Borderlands 2, generally, you don't have to farm for more than a few hours if you get very unlucky. Now, we did get very unlucky with trying to get the B shield at level, what was it? At like level 60 or something? Yeah. I think it was level 60 or 65 when we tried to get a new B shield. That was a very unlucky streak that we had. Okay, we're fine. Now, I'm very curious how it will sound in YouTube, actually, with these boar sounds. Might be a bit too loud. Oh well, nothing to do about that. That's just the game almost crashing. But yeah, we did get very unlucky on that level 65 Shem B shield, I believe. But other than that, we have achieved all the other goals relatively quickly. And yeah, the first time that we tried to get the Bada Boom was pretty unlucky. But then again, the very next time we came back to normal mode just to kill King Mong, we immediately found a better Bada Boom. Bouncing Betty. Oh! Okay, dodged it. That's blue, not pearlescent. Man, I'm always keeping my eyes open for a dastardly revolver, but nah. Dark Grip. Always keeping my eye out for pearlescent world drops with this guy. Oh, I thought that was a relic for a moment. purple relics, always worth watching for. Now, I do believe I have a mod installed that allows scavengers to be able to drop stockpile relics. But I haven't tested it out yet. Well, not for a long period of time, but I have played over 200 or 300 hours with the community patch enabled, with all the mods that I have. But so far, I have never found a stockpile relic from a scavenger yet. But then again, I don't kill too many scavengers, because you only find them in, like, the fridge area and in Lynchwood. And I haven't spent too much time in Lynchwood. Now, we will actually go to Lynchwood on this character as well, to find a good sheriff's badge. And a deputy's badge as well, because I do plan on doing shotgun builds with different characters. Especially with Salvador, of course, with Money Shot, because you know that's probably the best build in the game to do lots of stuff, actually. Okay, I should just aim carefully for the spawn. 76 stacks, wow. And, wow, that did nothing. Load and lock, that's 1500 loaders, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, that was damage cap, yep. That was the damage cap on that deception shot. Now, I purposely aimed for his top critical spot, because exploders have an even higher damage multiplier, critical hit multiplier on their, like, on that little thing that pops up above their head when they go into charge mode. Unfortunately... Ah, it looked like another pearlescent, like, again. Look at it. But it wasn't. Oh, why? 81 stacks. Damn. So, we did hit the damage cap with this muck-a-muck. That's very nice. I thought we were able to do that. But then again, that was a really high critical hit multiplier and over 80 stacks of critical ascension. So, and a deception shot with death mark. If that wasn't damage cap, then I would have been way too bad for OP8. Although we are, of course, rocking the Legendary Hunter class comm at the moment, and not the Legendary Sniper. But that's because I just... well... We can one-shot bunker anyways, right? We can just bore. So we don't need any sniper boosts. And that means my Shem has more capacity because I don't have to wear a sniper class comm. And we get more cooldown rates and also reload speed, which is good for rocket jumping. Now, I would like to find a Shem soon, because it has been 39 minutes so far, with zero Shams. Hey, zero. That's the character we're playing. Now, hopefully it will be above 80%, the Shem. It should be, you know, but... I don't need a perfect one, but I do like to have a decent one. But then again, let's first just try and find one. And then we'll complain about the parts if we need to. And once we get it, yeah, then I'll leave, but I might just come back later on to get a better one. Probably not gonna farm for a perfect one, because that is a real pain in the butt to farm for a perfect champ. It took Killer 6, another great Borderlands YouTuber, another, and then I don't mean compared to me, but compared to like Jilt's dude and other people. It took him about 2 years to finally find a perfect sham, I believe. And then he threw it off a cliff. And I believe he even deleted his Zero character that he used to farm for it. Okay, he's dead. That sounds like exploders. And he seems to be stuck. What is he doing? Oh, what? Where is he going? Oh, that was boar on him as well. Also, let's not die to stuff. Bunker Buster, that was a challenge. What was the challenge all about? I don't know. Alright, come on, sham, let's do it. Nope. Nope, nope, nope. Resource sniper rifle. Hyperion with a Hyperion grip. But it's not E-Tech, so then I do not want it. Like, at this point, for finding snipers, it's like, okay, we have these four Pimpernels, right? So, we also plan on getting all the Lyudas in the future. So, first thing I ask myself is this sniper better than either a Pimpernel or a Lyuda? In some cases, if the answer is no, I will not pick up that sniper. Maybe for ammo, maybe to sell it, but not to use it. Now, the bunker keeps on, like, bleeding out some more stuff and money, so sometimes he can drop a like a purple or even a world drop legendary very late, but this time it seems like he is done bleeding out. As far as bunkers can bleed, you know what I mean, pooping out loot, same thing. But then again, bunkers also don't poop. I think. Probably. And let's actually take a look at our badass rank, because we just completed like the loader challenge and the bunker buster. Ah, there we go. Gun damage, yeah. So at this point, we're getting some decent boost, especially like fire rate is 20% now. Some stuff is only like 15. 17, yeah. So if I were to disable badass rank, that would make quite a difference, like 20% all over the board. That's a lot of boosts I would definitely miss, especially like reload speed and fire rate. And I played like 400 hours to get those stats, you know? So I deserve them. And I will not disable them. Yeah, the Banbury fire rate is definitely noticeable compared to the old Pimpernel I used, the Monstrous, for max size. Now, thinking about it, like, retrospectively, like, 17 ammo on a slack Pimpernel is way too much. Like, on an offensive one, maybe. But for slag, you most of the time only like shoot once or twice and then switch to another weapon and then reload afterwards. Hey, a stockpile relic, grenade and pistol. Nope. So Monstrous on the slag is probably not the best prefix. Hey, a Ravager with a matching grip. Perfect, actually. So, almost sinewy. So it has a Hyperion stock and Torque grip, but that is definitely the best parts that you can have on shotguns. So we have two Ravagers now. I don't know what sinewy is. The stats are about the same. The reload speed is better. And yeah, I guess that's it. So this Ravager can go, and the other one we can keep. It's only 0.1 better in reload speed though, so not a huge difference. But still an improvement. Hey, is there a purple item now? Did I see that correctly? No, I'm like turning colorblind by this guy. Damn. Guy, machine, bunker, stuff, thing. So back to the chests. Oh, the purple sniper. Oh, not ETAC though, transaction. Hyperion, okay, no, that's not a good one.
And I disappear.
Should have used the deception for the movement speed bonus. Bit late now. Roughneck booster shield. Well, no thank you. For some reason I read roughneck as redneck. Don't ask why. I jumped over him. So the nice thing about this setup is that I do not have to switch out like my class mod or weapons or my relic. I can just do both killing. Oh, why is he so low? Oh! Oh my, that almost crashed the game. Luckily, almost, and not completely. Hee hee.
My boy's got supplies for you. Look for the buzzard with the white beads. Health incoming on the center platform. The crit I
vanish. And he is dead. I don't think I see a legendary. This is starting to get a bit annoying. Where is this guy? There. Wait, they didn't one-shot him? 21 stacks of critical ascension. He was slagged as well. Wow, I'm disappointed. Melee shield, a bunch of weapons over there. We looked at this, that's launcher damage, that's crap. Bloody ninja, nope. There's a blue thing, oh, handgun. And an amplify shield, that is not the B, so then it's awful. Let's use our deception boost this time for speed. Maybe this will get us something. Well, it was worth the shot, right? Well, unfortunately we didn't find anything yet, so let's just do one more run and then we'll have to end the episode for now, unfortunately. It's a shame, because I would really love to have gotten something here. Although we did get an improvement on our Ravager. It's quite nice. We haven't used it yet, but you know, we might do like a shotgun build later with the deputy's badge and cool stuff like that. And otherwise we'll maybe even transfer to our Axton once he becomes OP8, which is quite a long while from now. He can definitely make great use out of that. Also, Krieg. But first we'll have to complete the playthroughs with those characters. Alright, he's dead. Let's loot the chest while he's in his death animation stuff. Look for the buzzer with the white beacon. This is it, Bunker. Come on, I know you have the sham in there. Just give it to me. Give it to me. Never gonna share me. That's an Aegis, I think. Nope, a phobia, apparently. I don't use a lot of Malawan handguns, except for the grog nozzle. Well, he didn't drop us the sham, nor the bitch. Unfortunate, but true. It happens. We'll probably get it in the next episode. Let me quickly check if there's any stuff down here. Nah. Although, it's probably just iridium, otherwise I would probably... Yep. Well, thanks for nothing, Bunker. Alright, I don't want to go back to the chest, because then I'll have to walk all the way around. I'll end the episode here. We didn't find the sham this time, but we probably will in the next episode. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.